Susan, this is your first time working with Jay and Mark. They have a very particular style, sort of very open style that encourages improvisation, inspiration. So how was it sort of dealing with their way of working? Was
liberating, really great. I mean, they know what they're doing. Jason and Annette are brilliant at it. And Judy, I'd worked with before. I had an improvisational company years and years ago. And the great thing about that is that you're not concerned about whether or not, you know, something's right or wrong. You're just doing it and hoping it works, and you let them, you trust them, and so you don't have to work at being funny, or you're just kind of there. And what they do is actually start out pretty much close to the script. You find a way of where the camera's gonna be, and you talk about that a bit. Then, after they've gotten kind of what was in the script and everybody's familiar with that, then they kind of deconstruct. And so it's a little bit of both. But I'm a pretty good listener, so I like it. I like not knowing how things are going to turn out. I mean, if anything, I'm thinking maybe the next thing I would do is start directing documentaries, because I love so many brilliant documentaries that are being done now. And I love that process of not knowing where something, of being surprised. I like being surprised.
And does it feel more naturalistic in that way when you're acting? You know, you're not just sticking to a set script. You can sort of discover things as you
go
along.
Yeah, I mean, there are certain stories that don't lend themselves to that. And there are people who cannot really improvise because they just go off point and it goes on and on and on, and then it's not productive and you're there and, you know, it's not helpful. So it's not everybody that can do that.
And it does the job at the same time. The script is so good, you don't need to go anywhere else.
Yeah, well, I think that what they're trying to do is make you own it. It's not a question of whether or not the dialogue works or not. Because we did rewrite things before we went on set at times, you know. But again, those guys are just really great at it. So you're getting the best of the best. John C. Reilly, when he did Cyrus, you know, improvised a lot because he's really good at it too.
Something big you have coming up is you've reunited with the Wachowskis for Cloud Atlas.
Yeah.
Which we've been hearing some
things about. I've done, 8 movies this year. Little time, you know, not big parts. I'm diversifying my, so all my stocks aren't in one area. Mm-hmm. So if one film hits and it doesn't, you know, another one doesn't, I'm in 6 more. They asked me to go over to Berlin, and I do 4 or 5 characters, one male. Mm-hmm. And everybody was just throwing contact lenses in and different things. And I love the book, and I adore them. And so I was flattered to be asked to be part of this kind of circus that was happening, with all these people. But it's mostly Tom Hanks and Halle Berry, and there's a bunch of English actors that are really great. And but I really had a good time when I was there.
Okay.
And I think it's a hugely ambitious. Did you read the book, Cloud Atlas?
I have, actually, yes. And I almost can't see how they're going to make it, but
I know. Well, I'm not sure either. I saw, when I got there, they showed me 10 minutes, and it was like seeing 10 films. So I can't wait to see.